Power 106 FM. To advertise on Dear Pastor, call 968-488-0-3. This program may contain material which is suitable for mature audiences only. Parental discretion is advised.
Good evening, Jamaica.
Good evening, everybody.
Hello, friend. Hello, neighbor. Welcome to Dear Pastor. Today is Monday, September 29, 2014. And I'm Dr. Dumas, your host, and I'll be with you until midnight. Our song for this evening: does love not open your eyes?
Love.
Welcome back to Dear Pastor. I'm Dr. Dumas, your host, on this very beautiful evening here in downtown Kingston, Jamaica. I trust that you had a wonderful weekend. And I'm looking forward to enjoying my time here with you on the Dear Pastor Show. And I want you to feel free to call me if you have a problem. And if you would, you wish to comment on the topic. I want to heal everybody, everywhere, around the world. And those who are not feeling well, my prayers are with you. Please turn off your radio when you're calling the show. Don't be afraid to speak, but keep your comments short. I may ask you to hold if I believe that the contribution you are making is very helpful. To those of you who using your cell phones and you feel that we must answer immediately, I tell you the truth. Sometimes we cannot. You have to exercise patience. The numbers to call in studio are 922-4112, 922-4113, 922-4114, and 922-4115. We got to take a break.
Which is suitable for mature audiences only. Parental discretion is advised.
Welcome back to Dear Pastor After the Mass. The topic for this evening, why are today's women so bossy and controlling? Why are today's women so bossy and controlling? If you have a burning issue and like to talk to me about it, you may do so. You do not have to comment on the topic. Look, I don't want anybody calling me and trying to set me straight on religious matters. I'm on the Bible. We're not going to get anywhere with that, you see? And don't bother with politics on this show. Call the other shows, you know. I mean, you got Cliff Hughes and Joan Williams. You may call them and discuss politics with them. I know where I stand, but I don't comment. Listen, my show is not for that, you hear? A passing remark is good enough. But don't push any political agenda on my show. And don't push your religious beliefs either. All right, let me remind you that the topic Why are today's women so bossy and controlling? The email address is dumas.dearpastor@gmail.com. That's dumas.dearpastor@gmail.com. And the text line is 877-1009. Would you agree that today's women are very bossy and controlling? Why is that so? When you text them, give your first name. And I've said that so many times. You know, sometimes I would even like to help. But some folks just send a text. I don't know where it's coming from whom, and I'm not going to return a call. I'm not paying, using my money to call you, and I don't even know who you are. All right, let me take a call, please. Hello.
Good night, Pastor.
Yes, ma'am. How are you?
I'm not bad, thank you.
Uh-huh.
Well, according to it, not even one call, but Mr. Morgan, me must be the first call, and it really happened, but I wasn't going to call you. So I'm
beginning. How is it that you all always say that and end up calling?
Not going to call much again, you know.
Uh-huh.
I hail up Mr. Morgan and all the friends out here who like me. Big up to them.
Uh-huh.
And you know, I love the people who run the show and say what they want to say and what they want you to say.
Uh-huh.
You have your topic, and if we want to deal on the topic or something else, but not to run your business.
No.
Yes. And according to why women bash it to men, well, don't you know who they frighten, baby?
Yeah?
Don't you know who they frighten? So if anyone want, any man want put up in the basket, them a little small boy, that's why. But really, papa, no woman not supposed to boss around, no man and no man not even supposed to boss around, no woman have a decision and put together things.
Yes.
But they have so little man really, really love the basket business.
You mean that's a man who love to be love, pushed around?
Yes. There was men with no work in the yard. No work nothing in no way at all. Woman can't boss them around. But them not spill no much sense.
Really?
No spill no much sense at all, talk. So I'm not going to listen to you, but I'm going to have my bath.
All right, okay.
Long time you tell me, so I'm going to say, you know, I'm going to have my bath. I'm going to have my bath. All right.
All right, then. God bless.
Bless you.
Mm-hmm. All right. Yeah, maybe I should ask the guys if they're women, push them around, eh? You know the song? You wash my clothes? Yes, darling. You guys, that song, that song about you wash my clothes, yes, darling, you do so and so, yes, darling. I should have asked that song before I started the show. I'm sure we have it. Can I take a call, please? 9224114, 9224114, and 9224115. And the email is dumas.dearpastor nightime@gmail.com. And the text line is 877-1009. Let me take a break. Send me text right on the show. The lines here in studio are 922-411-225. Let me take a call. Hello. How are you?
What's going on, Chief?
I am doing well.
Man, I had a nice weekend, Pastor.
I am glad to hear that.
My three-team win, Pastor. University of Miami.
Yes.
Florida State.
Yes.
Miami Dolphins top it off yesterday evening.
Well, there you go. You had any? So you were watching and drinking?
Watching and eating.
Yeah?
No, my mama tell me now the drinking thing in our life.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, me give that up about 40 years ago.
Oh, okay, good.
Yeah, and right now, Kansas City killing Barry team.
Oh, yes?
Yeah, they got an early winter. Not too bad anyway, 27.
So Barry can't stand up right now?
Maybe. Maybe he's a low roller right now. He can't be the high rolling right
now. Ay, ay, ay. So all is well.
Yeah, man.
Now you want to come into my topic tonight?
Pastor.
Why are today's women so bossy and controlling?
You know, I have not today, woman, you know, Pastor. I have one yesterday, woman. So, no woman, them are from a wife of a long time, old timer. So, she know, you know, the bossy thing. No. I think you get what you pay for, Pastor. You know, you got to know when to hold and know when to fold. You know what I mean?
Well, you know, I'm learning a lot from you.
If you, you have to have your pointers in your life, you know. You have to have your telltale signs from day one if it's gonna work, if you're gonna get bossed around. And nobody should boss nobody around. No man should boss a woman around, and no woman should boss no man around. You know, you should have mutual understanding. And just deal with the thing, you know?
Yes, but there are some women who are rather bossy, don't you think so?
Pastor, I speak the truth all the time, you know, I tell you. See, the woman, them, we have a lot of storage, you know, I have to fix it up. The woman, them, we have a lot of storage. Them bossy. But I don't know if you know me when I say they have a lot of storage.
I'm a very innocent man, if I may say so myself.
Yeah.
So you would have to put it another way so that I would understand.
Pastor, I don't know. I don't want to get cursed out, you know.
They have a lot of storage.
They got a lot of storage. You don't want to put it in a nice way. The women, them, we have a lot of storage. They always have some attitude. I notice that. All over the world, they have a... The women, them, with a lot of storage, you know. They tend to... I don't know, maybe they don't feel secure with their husband or their boyfriend. So they always get mad and try to boss up their husband or their boyfriend. The little slim girl, them, the slim woman, the petite woman, then they behave themselves.
Really?
Yeah. Not all of them, you know, but most of them behave themselves. The woman, them, where, you know, I understand when I say the woman them, with the story.
I understand what you mean, sir.
But I never have them problem then, no, Pastor.
Mm-hmm.
At my age and our old bug like me, me never really get into them situations. I'm kind of sorry for the people them who really accept those type of behavior. But it's definitely not acceptable. It's not good. You know, talk to your husband or your boyfriend in public like they ain't anything, you know. And some of the guys, them are real men. They just don't want to talk back. You understand? They were trained to behave themselves. You know?
Yes.
So they just, people might say, oh, why that woman treat that man so rough? But the guys are well trained, you know. They're trained, so they just mop it up. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
That's how. You know, they, when you put a sponge in the water, right, they just suck up the water.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? And then the beer, because, you know, when you have behavior, no matter how it goes, sometimes you're going to, you're going to show good character.
Mm, but, huh?
I'm glad I've never been in those situations. So, you know,
but a woman who is very bossy,
yeah.
Isn't she running an intelligent man? A woman who is very bossy,
yes.
Isn't she running an intelligent man away from her?
Yes. 90% of the time it happens, you know?
Mm-hmm.
They just take off.
Mm-hmm. All right. It's good to hear from you, sir.
All right, Pastor. Hey, you didn't watch that thing last night, Pastor?
Evidently, I tuned in too late, man.
They will repeat it.
Yeah.
All right, Pastor. Take it easy.
All right, good.
Yeah, bye-bye.
9224113 9224114 9224115. And I tell you what I'm going to do, you know, I'm going to start reading the text messages early. Because believe it or not, you know, sometimes there are so many of them and then I feel very guilty. So, I'm going to start doing that. In fact, and then I also had a rush on Thursday night to read comments on Facebook. I've waited for the last two shows too late to start reading the comments, and some of them, and there were many. Here is a text on our topic, sir. It's because plenty of the women these days. Generally, when I read these texts, and I'm reading it as they are written, some of them are not written in standard English, and so, and you know, so please understand. Because plenty of the women these days are more independent, or because some of them have more than one man, so they think they can be bossy. All right, let me take a call. Hello, welcome to Dear Pastor.
Dear Pastor, how are you, sir? Good night.
I am doing very well, giving God thanks.
Dear Pastor, the language that it takes, and of me, you know, man, you have to get one young lady, make sure you read nighttime. No disrespect, man. No disrespect, Pastor. But the language that they're using at it
yes.
Is enough for me, you know, for age, you know?
Yes, I understand.
That's true, Pastor. And no disrespect, you know?
No, I understand, you know.
Because, Papa, Pastor,
mm-hmm.
These young people, English not for them language, you know? Because if you ever see how they write the text, you have to actually verse and understand them writing.
And my problem is I don't have much time to try to read and understand what they're trying to say.
Yeah, man, get to a young lady, make sure you read.
Well, you know.
Respect, no disrespect, yeah?
Well, I could answer you that and tell you why I can't.
Pastor, no disrespect.
All right. Take it easy. He's correct, isn't he? He is, yeah. All right. 9224112 9224113 9224114 and 9224115. Again, the text line 8771009. Let me take the break.
Suitable for mature audiences only. Parent discretion is advised.
Welcome back to Dear Pastor. I'm Dr. Dumas, your host. Take a... Well, the topic. Why are today's women so bossy and controlling? Is your woman like that? Bossy and controlling? Here is a text. Only men with low self-esteem, esteem, get pushed around. Is that true though? Only men with low self-esteem? I don't know. I don't think I totally agree with this comment. 9224112, 9224114, 9224114, 9224115. And the email address is mass.thepastor@gmail.com. Hey, go to Facebook page, my Facebook page, Dear Pastor J.A. That's Dear Pastor J.A. And post your comments on the topic, and I'll read your comments during the show. That's a Facebook page, Dear Pastor J. Let me take another call. Hello, welcome to Dear Pastor.
Good night, Pastor.
And how are you?
I'm very sad.
You're very sad?
Not really. You say why some women are so bosses, because they want someone to probably push around, and sometimes you want the man to do something for you, and you're not up to it, so you have to boss them up at times, and if you know that you want them to be honor and do whatever you feel like.
So you might want the man to do something?
Yeah.
And he is reluctant.
Yeah.
And so you start to boss him around and how you do that?
Yes, I use it as a revenge. When I was growing up, my father used to push me around, and everything he called on me to do now. So when I'm with the man now, I wanted to do everything for me. So I said, I would take up the problem and I said, go and do this, go and do that, go out to shop, go buy it, go cook, go do this. If you don't do that now, then I'm gonna have a fun.
Really?
Yeah, I took out the revenge what I need to go through. So if I can't boss up and he can't do anything for me, I don't think I'm going to settle down with that.
You try that with your boyfriend?
Yes, but sometimes it works with it and sometimes it doesn't work with it. When it doesn't work with the flow, we keep malice. Sometimes we work with it and that is good enough.
So you're still with this man?
Yes.
And he has, but sometimes he ignores you.
Yeah.
Have you ever called my show?
No, it's the first time I'm calling, Dear Pastor.
You're...
I think I'd like to talk to you off the air, but this is not my topic tonight. But because I draw this topic tonight, I said I would like to make a comment.
Yes, and I appreciate that so much.
Yes.
Well, you could always, if you want, you could stay on the line, and my assistant will give you my number.
Yes, sir. I would appreciate that very much.
Well, you stay on the line, and he'll give it to you.
Okay.
And thank you for calling.
Yes, sir.
Bye-bye. Let me take another call. Hello.
Good evening, Pastor.
Hello, how are you?
Oh, I'm okay. And you?
I'm doing well. I give God thanks.
Okay, me too. But Pastor, your topic, your topic, they always get more and more difficult to me.
No, this is not this one not difficult.
What is today, woman?
What? Like you.
Me not today, woman.
Yes, very much so.
Today, woman is not one of the young girls, them.
No. But listen, you're not an old woman in any case.
I want to get it right. The guy look like this. You sound like today, woman is like most people. When people talk about today, woman, it sounds like I wanted the young people. Then what me a today, woman do?
Well, that's well. No, you are agreeing with me, because
this
includes you. Yes,
I'm a part of the society.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm today, woman too.
Indeed.
I don't want to talk, but your caller will say, I would like him to explain, I still don't understand what woman with lot of baggage, what is that? I don't understand that. I would love to get that straight.
Pastor,
and you ask him, he says something, you ask him, we're talking, he's not criticizing. You ask him something if he want to comment, and he didn't want to comment because he was old or something like that. But if I remember good, I think I hear the same guy say one time his wife was 30 years younger than him.
I think she's either 20 or 30, yes.
So he's supposed to have a lot to think, to say about both old and young.
Yes.
I'm listening.
All right. Love you.
I span up the abyss, my sweetie pipes, man.
Then what you going on with, June?
I want Robert call.
All right, bye-bye.
Pastor, me have a lot of boyfriend, you know, Pastor.
It would seem so.
And me husband don't jealous because he know that I'm just a nice, kind, joking person.
Yes, I know, and thank God for you.
Okay, darling.
Bye-bye. Oh, my. Yes, he talked about when baggage, and I know what he's saying, but let him call back and explain. Why are today's women so bossy and controlling? The email address is dumas.theirpastor@gmail.com. dumas.theirpastor@gmail.com. Let me take a call, please. Hello.
Hi there, Pastor. Good night.
And how are you?
Not too bad.
Uh-huh. Turn off that radio in the background or television or whatever.
With your topic, turn off, Pastor.
Please, I beg you. There's noise in the background there.
Yeah, remember, where I am, you know.
Where are you?
I'm down in the market, so you know what's good.
Okay, yes, all right.
So, with the Bossy thing, and the Bossy thing, I feel why it happened is because man water down themselves now. They water down themselves in both attitude and everything. And now it left up to the woman. If you notice nowadays, it's like, I don't know. And it's like, them have two heads, but it's like them most penetrate one to use.
Well, what do you mean by that?
You know, them have the bottom one and the top one, and then penetrate the bottom one more. Yeah, y'all laugh.
Man, listen to me.
And more time the turn them fool, you know.
Yeah?
Yeah, more
time. So let me ask this question. You're saying that every man has two heads?
Of course.
Really?
Yes.
What is
that? And true that now them use one more than the other one and then use a call care. We woman, you know, so we not get our head alone, so we are attacking your style, you know, we get it to use.
Mm-hmm.
But then get one of them head to use and return them fool. So for them, mastership for them should have up or what I call it, it gone. I don't know why. Them left up everything to woman. Where the should strong, that's where they fall. I don't know. Yeah, you know,
well,
they should even have authority. They are not there. If you notice, in a pastor.
Yes.
Notice, you know, enough things now. And most of the women, you see, push up them head. Well, already, I feel good when I hear that the boys, them now, is like them sit around and start, come up, you know, them education now.
Mm-hmm.
A couple of years ago, you never hear them say, boy, I do nothing.
Yeah.
You say, you know, I feel good now for you, say, some boys come up and get some, you know, re-up scores.
Yes.
It's not just a woman alone. What's happened to the men? And what really happened, you know, some man realize, you know, say, the good book teller say, the only way you get a good wife, you know, is if you please God, you know.
Yes.
Some man will go around with don't please God, them now. Get a good wife, you know, get a wife, will get them born. Easter and all the vehicle alongside with it, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah. Them go and get it and they don't like to get born.
Uh-huh.
But it's going to happen. Because I thought them angle themselves, them battered on themselves, and it's the truth. Compromise.
Mm.
It's true. It's true, you know.
Yes.
What's that if them lazy and I depend upon the woman of the yard? Judgment. That's how the boss man coming. Yeah, man.
Mm-hmm.
John still can't get you, you know, because you know, I don't know what. Anyway, glad to hear you, and good night to each and every one here and abroad.
Mm-hmm. All right, take it easy.
All right, baby. Love you.
You love you too. Good. Awesome. Let me take another call. Hello.
Yeah, Pastor.
Mm-hmm.
I give my sympathy to Mr. Morgan. He lost about 3 persons. He lost his sister from the flu, and his nephew was going to see what's going on with the aunt, why she died, he crashed and died, and the first problem must be with traveling with him, somebody that died.
When was that?
Since sometime here, you know, he told me the other day, I don't remember, but
mm-hmm.
So I give my sympathy and so forth, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And when my days, I didn't take my baggage. What I call my baggage, my children, I didn't bother look another man so sorry for them because I didn't want them come and mess around them or mess around me.
Yeah.
And Pastor, sometimes when I call your show, it's like you don't want to hear me at all, you know.
Who don't want to hear you?
And that's the God truth. And
now, hold on.
Other people listen to and say too.
You come on, Grandma.
And is it God?
Well, wait now.
Me no go back and do go talk.
You are saying that I don't want to hear you?
Some of the time, lots of time, even tonight.
Grandma, come on. No, you see, come on and listen. Grandma, listen. I have never been rude to you.
No, you never.
No, hold on. Let me speak. I have never been rude to you. I have never won evening said to any of my assistants not to take your calls. I have always facilitated. And for you to say that really upset me. And you should do better than that. I did not expect you to say that. No, I didn't. And Grandma, you must apologize for what you've said. Because I have never objected to taking your calls. I expect you to apologize. Alright, listen to me. I expect you to apologize.
I still love you.
Alright, no. And I'm not. Okay, fine. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
That's been nasty. Very, very nasty. I didn't expect Grandma to say that. And I have never done what she's saying. Let me take the break. Now, you see, that is not right, especially when you know you have gone overboard.
Pastor.
You know, I don't appreciate that, you know, and it has nothing to do with grandma's age. Grandma must speak the truth and learn to control herself.
Pastor, I know that she going to come and cuss me out like how she did.
No, but it's not right for grandma to say that. When we here at this station, and I know when I speak for myself, and I know that the other podcasters love her and appreciate her. And you're not them to the show and accusing me like that.
You should have picked up that from a long, long, long time ago. When Grandma Yvonne came on and said, when you really, when her time to come on, it's cut out. They never fucked up. I never remember that.
No, but you see, they never about it, you know.
No.
In fact, one of the men just said to me a while ago, that's not good. They're not belittling women these days. But Grandma, you see, she can talk about whatever she wants about somebody else, but don't say that about me. I've never done it. Never refused what I said to her. Never! And she and Grandma used to be ashamed of all that. I must apologize, you know? Alright, you do it.
For a long while, Grandma said, like she would say that, she only know you and Mr. Bar, and she don't know why she keep pushing her out and the real get. I know that was for me enough, you know. Anyway, on the topic, why some women are so bossy?
Why are these women so bossy and controlling?
I would say because most of the men are very slight.
Is that right?
Yes. I mean, I have a man inside here now, and I want a nail to go right here, so he can't see that I would have to go outside and get somebody to do it. I mean, he's slight.
Mm.
So, I mean, if I have to go and get somebody outside to do it, yes, I would also get bossy. Right now, my fan starts to crease free. You understand?
Mm.
I will pull it right down, clean it and oil it. And the little man is there, he's not doing it. So I just get the one on the bossy. That's really true.
In other words, a fool man, eh?
Hmm?
He's a fool man if you can boss him around.
Well, because he's slight.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
Because he's slight.
All right, take it easy.
Anyway, me hope Grandma will come apologize to you, you know, but... Why? Lillian, Ota had a bad.
And I don't appreciate that at all.
I never expect that from her, but I was looking for it because... All the while when she keep complaining about the replay and they cut her out and things like that. I don't know. Okay, take care.
God be with you.
You're cool.
Take a break.
You're listening to Power 106 FM. The time is now...
16 and a half minutes after 10.
We have a vision of a connected world.
Welcome back to Dear Pastor. I'm Dr. Dumas, your host. Let me take a call. Hello.
Yes, Reverend.
How are you?
I'm not doing so well, doctor, because I'm not doing so well with my stomach, you know.
Oh, I'm sorry about that.
I suffer shut a bit.
Did you go to the doctor?
Yes, several times.
Yes.
And the pastor, tonight, you see, I didn't prepare to think about the topic because that topic is for younger people, they might believe. But I have a lot of experience in those ideas, in those ways.
Yes.
But I believe that a right man who knows what he's about into a relationship, he will prepare to take a push around faster.
Mm-hmm.
The right, decent, intelligent lady would prepare to push around her boyfriend or her husband. No pastor, because it will seem that it is lesser than you. One is lesser. The both of us pastor are supposed to be equal. And you don't give me sex only when you feel like yourself. You don't cook only when you want to cook. Because of both of us.
Yes.
I believe in those attitudes. So a right man pastor like me then, you might go push it in my diesel pastor. You know, I wanted to push around in front of my female friend and pastor. Because what in my home, I responsible for you and whatever is in the home. You must be responsible for me also too. So both of us need to be equally urged for each other.
Mm-hmm.
So it's people who think less about the other one, why do you think I'm pastor? Mm-hmm. You know, pastor, that is about a little part of that now. Today, I would rather you're good for your pastor. So we have not been unadequate in any way because I'm not here to show you paper business.
Mm-hmm.
But he's a big friend. He's a friend of mine too, but he don't take me for a friend, but I see him as a friend because we are big people. Can I call his name?
Yeah, man.
He's Mr. Will, you know.
Yes.
Yes, he's Mr. Will. I know he could be listening to me and give him a seat. He's after me and say, but I'm calling him to talk about his business. But anyway, he was pretty happy, you know.
Uh-huh.
No, pastor, you know what I'm about chiefly?
Uh-huh.
One night last week, I had a father call you about his son.
Uh-huh.
And pastor, when I look into what he said, I agree with him. And the pastor, I look to all about sons up these days. Some of them, not all of us. Not all the boys, but some of us, pastor, with our some of our son. They are tired of their father living in the situation, in what them come see with, you know, sir.
Mm.
Some son father to the pastor hate to see their father living because they want to take over. And they don't love their father because they feel that their father is in their way.
Mm.
You know what I said, pastor?
Mm-hmm.
I'm speaking of my own experience, pastor.
Yes.
Pastor, I am living in a little community named Prospect, and my name is Mas Papsi.
Yes.
And a lot of people are, you know, say, I call them and say, yeah, you say, yeah, Mas Papsi there. And pastor, I don't want nobody to praise me because I'm praised by most of the community people.
Yes.
The teachers and all those people. As one of the best father in this district, pastor.
Yes.
I can't overwatch the children then. And to the pastor, I just see myself in 2 Timothy 3rd chapter. Pastor, you know, it's about 2 months ago. When I have my son take up his high hands to let me come outside the Philippine room, pastor.
Are you serious?
I'm telling you, pastor, I'm talking. Some people heard about it already because it was affecting. It was about his friend. That ball of him. But ball after him. Pastor, maybe today I would be on the phone talking to you. I'm telling you, pastor. And what do you think of the pastor? Is because of my one thing that I had, the old yard with me when go, and the old breadfruit tree and the old pig pen and the old cane field, pastor, I'm come back to use it. And pastor, is a son that I job firing 19 in the '80s, the backside industry year. And pastor, believe you me. You know, pastor, you have to see my situation. So pastor, I know that some children today, they don't want to see their parents live. Because what my son is against before is because he wants to come and use all the things that I should get a good benefit from. And don't promise to be able to give me, want to give me anything. Because I speak of it, pastor, in turn against me like a devil in hell. And this is second time my pastor, my son, attempt to let me down. I'm the same all the other stuff. About sometime last year, in Grand Fish, beat me out because I was quarreling. And then the next thing that is was right there, chef was close together. Because I was passing each other about one another.
Yeah.
And when the giant fish and get each passer, left some ball at him, I mean his friend. And his last time, in the last 3 months ago, passer, he said, I asked where my stepson make, my stepson up, building trade. And he makes some iron stool here before he go away. And Pastor Dumas, remember my son, take it up, because he get eaten against me, because I don't have enough time to destroy, you know. But Pastor, if it wasn't his friend that bothered him, tonight I wouldn't be on the phone here talking to you. Maybe he would be...
How old is this young man?
He's 52 years
old. Why is a big, he's a grown man behaving, sir?
My grandfather, Pastor, and I get a job for him at 19, in the 80s at the bus. He's there now, Pastor, if he's not at work. And he came that he's improving down to supervisor. But Pastor, not for the devil in hell, Pastor, the man would leave the whole yard. All him, my Pastor, is his daddy dead. The king can take over. And Pastor, before I leave, because of that, no, Pastor, because of him, those are children, they take away from me also, too, because they're not improving the whole house, yeah? Because he's not spending money for it, and if he has said that, when that the Pastor, for him, I couldn't take over. And he never had money yet, Pastor. The buy-back feed, we feed him to them. We go to church, Pastor, we see my shop, we stop friendly with him, buy me 2 beer, and we was friendly, Pastor, because we get back. The first incident, we pass it over because some Christian people call the family one day and get our family together. And he came back. And Pastor, you know, Pastor, I don't want to keep longer issue, see?
No, but I want to hear because yes, we love you and we respect you.
Thank you, sir. And Pastor, I am seeing where some of our children, when we get old, they don't want we to be around. While some of them don't want mama and daddy to pass her. But there are children today, they pass her that some of what you see dead, you know, sir. And we as soon as that I said, look, you know, forget we offer them want the place to sell. I want the house to do for them business. And because you are dead, they can't sell it. And then they said, and then set your pastor, I believe. Because right now, pastor, I'm not happy with my safety. I live alone. And I see where some of the children them grudgeful pastor. Even that one day, he's living with grudge. He don't love his other brother and sister them. He don't want to come to marriage or whatever. He want to just control. But pastor, me and the mother part separate, you know. Yes, we are divorced family.
Yes.
So I alone live at the matrimonial home here. But this home is belonging to me and my previous wife. I can't do law, you know, sir?
Yeah.
Yes, we are gentle account for the property here. So I can't give it to anybody. So when the pastor passes, he will be the man that can take over. So then the mother one no pastor, you not improve on your law, sir, because in the harmony yet. And they're not helping me either. So pastor, I can't even explain to you. I am the one that say I have 16 children, Pastor.
Oh, I know who you are, man. I know who you are.
10 of them here, Pastor. 10 of them.
I know who you are.
And one of the best ones to me, Pastor, is my stepson, you know. One of the best, that young man used a hard word to me yet. I would say hard word.
Well, listen, I have to take the break now, but before I go, let me tell you. You don't worry, I'll back you up in prayer.
Yes, Pastor. Very good, Pastor. Thank you for that word.
All right.
And I will call you back on the next
day. Yes, man. Keep strong. All right.
Bye.
Good. Let's take the break. Welcome back to Dear Pastor, I'm Dr. Dumas. your host. Let me take a call. Hello.
Yeah, Pastor.
Yes, ma'am.
I wasn't blaming you that you put not cutting me off, you know.
No, Grandma. Grandma. No, I want you to know I heard what you said, and it's on tape. You said that I don't want to hear you, and you're telling me the truth. You said that, and it is not true.
Pastor, no, I listen to what I said. I say you answer me sometimes quakey. Not loving and nice. Like
no, you did not. Yes, no. You did that's not say that. Listen, Grandma. I have respect for you. I do. And I do not like anybody who calls me here and lie. Because you accuse me of something I did not do. Listen to me. And that. And that. No, but.
That little loving.
But that is not true.
You used to be loving and good. And you answer me quick and I don't like it.
Listen, Grandma.
And dear Pastor, listen to me. I still hang up.
No, but you're not going to hang up. I'm not going to allow you to do what you want on this show. I'm not going to do it.
Everybody.
Said I am not going to allow you. And until you apologize, I don't want to hear you. Let's go on. Hello, welcome to the Pastor.
Good evening, Pastor.
Yes, sir, how are you doing?
I am fine, thank you.
Good to hear you, man.
And it's good to hear you. If not asking, see, it's not the most auspicious moment to phone.
No, but that's all right. That's all right. That's all right. You see what Grandma has done to me? I feel it, and I tell you why. I respect age so much. And and I have been very respectful to Grandma. And anybody who listens to me, who, you know, here, would know that. And she's...
I'm glad you said
You know what I mean?
I'm glad you said that, Pastor, because we all heard what Grandma said, and it wasn't fair. It was a lie. Yeah?
He's not the story, track.
Yes!
And, you know... she does have a little bit of a malignant spirit to her anyway.
Yeah.
And, she always had it, you know. I mean, like, she can sort of relate her, experience as well. But, you know, we see how she reacts to certain other things anyway. And, you know, she just deliberately came on there and I don't know what got into her over the weekend.
Yeah.
But she deliberately came out to accuse you of wrongdoing.
Yeah. And I don't appreciate that at all.
No, it's not fair, Pastor.
So what's going on?
Nothing too much, Pastor. We're surviving as usual. Yeah. Watching to see how whether or not Ice School is going to come and take us over soon.
What going to take us over? What is it?
ISO. ISO, you know, because, they won't stop. Where, you know, even if they took over Iraq, they wouldn't stop there anyway.
Well, I tell you the truth, you know. I want you to tell me, and I'm glad you called tonight, because I suppose you would have the answer. What's the answer?
There's no answer, because they can't negotiate with them.
Right.
They can't, there's no kind of negotiating, because why should they? They have the power. So there's no negotiating, and you know America is afraid to put any more feet on the ground, as they say.
Boots on the ground. Mm-hmm.
Boots on the ground. So eventually, you know, it's a nightmare scenario. What would happen? Because you see, there's too many vested interests, and you know all the players in there. You know they're all culpable. You know everyone have something to do with it, and some people are earning money. Some people are buying oil. The Turks are buying oil now at $40 a barrel, you know, from ISIL, right?
Yeah.
So, and the Turks have no interest in seeing the Kurds getting any power in that region because
that's it.
Right. So, and you know, the Israelis and the Saudis, they would love ISIL to move in on the Iranians.
Do you think that they would, eh?
Oh, yeah, yeah, they definitely would. Yeah, they definitely would love that, because that would be the threat to the Israelis gone, and the Saudis would sort that their Muslim, sort of this dynasty, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
It's all about the Hashemite dynasty, yeah? Because Islam is split between, the Hashemites and the Fatimids, or the Arabs, So it's all about, either the democracy or nepotism, because they chopped the prophet's head, Zadson's head off the same way as well.
Yeah. The thing about it, according to the report, these guys are so wealthy.
Yes, they are. Because I tell you what, you see all those guys who joined the pastor, they're all graduates. They're brilliant kids, But they're just bored. They have money and they're bored. And so basically, this is what it's all about, And, they love their drugs as well, I must say. So they're having a spree, basically. And, eventually, if they manage to take everything over, the nightmare scenario is that Israel would have to nuke, Turkey, Iraq, Syria, Egypt. Well, they'd have to wipe out all the Arabs, because, you can't just wipe out one and leave the rest just to come at you.
But answer me this question. They claim to be Muslims. How is it then that they could ravish women and at the same time claim to be Muslims? Because the Muslims have believed over the years that women are to be respected.
Well, you see what it is, Pastor. The Quran has, an answer for every kind of scenario.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're a Muslim and you see another Muslim doing something, no matter if it's un-Islamic, it's not for you to question him about it or say he's not a good Muslim, because the thing is that fidelity is a secret between man and God.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not for you to judge,
mm-hmm.
So basically, that's their excuse for doing that, And Islam, to be quiet, and people say, who radicalized them, It doesn't take any imam to do that.
Mm.
The Quran itself does it. The Quran, all you need is the Quran. The highest principle in the Quran, of course, is forgiveness, and that's a top level. But right down, the natural instinct is like the animal thing.
Yeah.
Revenge, an eye for an eye, and
Yes.
And just go on a rampage in this situation. Even in Saudi Arabia, they used to have the raid. That thing called the raid, it was just outlawed not so long ago.
Mm-hmm.
Which the raid basically is that, if you're at your home and, or in your oasis or what have you, your tribe is sitting here and there's nothing happening to you. And every night, another tribe further away in the distance is having a party. Well, it's your duty to go and, raid him and feed him. Of course, it's all the provisions of Allah.
Okay.
So to make up for that bad deed, what you do is give, you give hostage or you give hospitality. So you have to share that thing that you've just holding to, somebody who comes along in need.
All right. I want you to hold. Let me take the break and come back to you. Please. All right. Welcome back, my dear brother. I'm sorry for the long break.
It's okay, Pastor. Your fault, was it? We all get sail to Austin sometime.
You gotta, we got to make some money.
But regarding the treatment of women in Islam, though, you know, Islam does actually, you know, there's equality for women in Islam.
Yeah,
there's no discrimination. It's just that, you know, to bring in cultural, you know, practices and try to make it Islam, it's not true. And this is why they don't encourage their women to get educated, so that they don't read the Quran and find the truth out.
Yeah, well, see, this is what bothers me when I hear, and you know, we could only accept the report. You know, well, we don't have to accept what we hear, but but you hear about so many women being being sexually abused. You know, and they're raped and then you wonder, you know. I mean, you go, if you are, if they are acting like missionaries, okay, you have to give up your faith, if you know, and become a Muslim. You know what I mean? And on the other hand, you hear them abusing so many women.
Well, this is it. This is it. You know, as I said to you, I mean, like, this is just pure. That is not Islam. Definitely not. And, you know, and if they're talking about they're having a jihad or what have you, you know, a holy war, I mean, the first jihad was nothing like that, you know?
Yeah.
That's why the Christians are still there. Mm-hmm. And that's why all the minorities are still there.
Mm-hmm.
These are just kind of psychos.
Yeah.
They're just, yeah, psychopaths, and that's basically it, you know? And sorry, and about your subject, before I forget, yeah, regarding, what you say, women, Bossy women?
The topic tonight is why are today's women so bossy and controlling?
Well, you see, we don't have that problem in London. It's not really something we have to deal with. We were voted earlier on this year by some United Nations women group for equality. London was voted as the most chauvinistic city in the world.
Is that right?
Yes. And, you know, we keep it simple. It's very simple. We have a simple motto in London. Treat them mean, keep them keen.
But I hear I hear people talking about the parliament dominated by men.
Yeah, isn't that right?
Mm-hmm. I remember, I'm old enough to remember when Margaret Thatcher gave a speech many years ago and was hoping that things would change, and then she made a statement that it would not happen in her lifetime. But having said so, she became a prime minister.
Well, of course, you know, but, you know, by the same token, you know, I've heard conservative MPs, you know, telling some MPs that, you know, I mean, like, she was menopausal. She asked the question.
I see what you're saying, yes, yes, yes.
Well, I think you've been a bit menopausal.
Yeah, she had her aim.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Huh?
Yes, yes, yes. So basically, as I say, but you know, of course, you're going to have some substance to be that way, yeah? Because there's no point you living in a woman's house and you're not in control of your, you know, own destiny to be saying things like that to her, or, you know, treating her mean. So when she calls you and tells you to wash up and clean up and what have you, just get on with it.
I was trying to ask the guys if we could find that song. And all I could remember with the song is that you wash my clothes, yes, darling, you did so and so, yes, darling.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to try and speak.
I didn't see anything compromising, but I keep quiet.
Yes. Always good hearing from you, man.
About incidentally, Pastor.
Yeah.
You know that old guy a while ago? He was just talking to you about his son.
Yes.
Now, I find it a bit peculiar because I remember him nearly biting New Jersey's head off when New Jersey suggested that he had 16 children, and he was saying he didn't. And I'm sure that that's what he said when he first came on the show.
Yeah, but he said it a while ago that he has 16.
Exactly, but you remember New Jersey mentioned it. Yeah, I mean, all right, I did put a bit about the obvious man as well, right? Mm. But he was going to be, you know, he was ferocious. He was furious. He was coming in there,
yes,
you know, blaspheming, yeah, cursing and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, New Jersey couldn't even defend himself. You know, and I was so disappointed in anyway.
But anyhow, though, you know, it is very sad to, for a man to have a son and the son is 50 years old and abusing his father like that, though.
You want to see my boys, right? Yeah, in the gym, right?
Yeah.
You know what I have to do? Yeah. Occasionally, we have to have little boxing rounds together, you know?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Oh, gosh. take life easy.
Take it easy,
Pastor. Okay, bye-bye. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Sir. Take another call, please. Hello. Hello.
Good night, Pastor.
Yes.
Yes. Anyway, don't worry yourself about Grandma. Grandma is just here like that.
Yeah, but Grandma should be respectful to everybody.
Yes, to everybody. And anyway, it's nothing really I call about.
Mm.
The gentleman who says son is trying to abuse him.
Yes.
That son don't have no ambition.
Mm.
And if he don't have no ambition, I'm not going to get it nowhere better from that.
Yes.
You must just put in trust to God and pray to God so God help him and change. But when a child not have no ambition, it's not easy. For a child cannot be 50 had a year old and coming to want to lick down his father.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever I have. That son should look in for his children. Prepare for his children and his grandchildren.
Mm.
Instead looking to his father. You understand?
I agree with you.
He don't have no ambition.
But you say ambition and respect.
Yes.
He doesn't have either.
Not ambition and no respect.
No.
And he's looking for himself and his children and grandchildren. You understand?
Mm.
Just don't have no ambition and no respect. So no matter what the father do, if home has to try to take care of himself.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sick.
Mm-hmm.
He must try to take care of himself and don't worry over them.
I agree with you.
Yes.
All is well with you?
No, I have a chicken gunner.
Hey, stay far with that. although they say, you know, that is only, you can only get it from mosquito.
No, look, it's more than mosquito. Come here, like more than mosquito.
No, with all seriousness, what are you taking?
Me? I drink plenty of coconut water.
Right.
I drink lots of coconut water.
Mm.
I don't say I must take liquid.
Mm.
I afraid to get diabetes. So make keep away from sweet drinks. I just drink coconut water for me in the country. I can't get coconut.
Oh, you can get that from in rural Jamaica.
I have coconut for myself, so I just pick it out of the tree.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Every day I have like 2 or 3 coconuts for the day.
All right.
Yes. Water.
Well, tell me exactly where you are.
I am in West Prospect, Bagwalk.
Oh, you're in Bagwalk, yes. Mm-hmm.
Yes. Anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And I take the acetamental.
Yes.
And the somebody introduced me now to Bossy.
Oh, yes, I've heard people saying that.
Yes, I may get the Bossy and boil and drink it. So, you know, I'm trying to take the medical thing. I'm taking
it. All right, you're going to bounce back, man.
Yes, yeah, man.
Love you.
You're not so bad, you know, I can't, all this crushing I have now.
All right.
That was so wonder 100% right from morning.
Uh-huh.
I did have foot problem.
Okay.
In the foot answer. Mm-hmm. So the chicken come and me eat. Anyway, me kind of get up back.
Thank God. Mm-hmm. Love you and thank you for calling.
Yes, Pastor. Take care. I listen a long time. What happened to number two, Grandma?
I haven't heard from her for a while.
Long time in a year.
Uh-huh. Okay, but you have called me before.
One time,
okay. God bless you.
Take care, Pastor.
You too, okay. Bye-bye. We take a break. Welcome back to Dear Pastor. I'm Dr. Dumas, your host. All right, may I give the topic again? Why are today's women so bossy and controlling? Let me take a call. Hello.
Pastor.
Yes, sir?
I just have to call back.
Uh-huh.
First thing, your program teaching everybody who listens all over the world.
Yes.
There's a thing that says once a man, twice a...
Twice a child.
That's it. So grandma can be forgiven. Trigger you off. Grandma eat something that wasn't good for her tonight. Maybe some salt mackerel. You know, you're not laughing tonight, you know, Pastor.
Mm-hmm.
You're not laughing tonight. And I can tell you're not feeling too well. When I say not feeling too well, you know, your energy is knocked out, like you get a punch in the gut.
Really?
Yeah. Like somebody punch you in the belly. You know when you get a punch in the gut?
Uh-huh.
So you just spark it up. Just laugh it off, because grandma is good, but she eats something that wasn't good for her tonight. Maybe some salt mackerel and something that wasn't good. So it triggered her off. You know, from the first time she started talking, you could tell something wasn't right. You know? When she says she's going to take a bath and she called John Brown and she's going to take a bath. You know, that can tell you grandma wasn't all the way there.
Yeah, well, I think you are very kind.
Yes.
Mm.
I have old people to deal with in my life.
Uh-huh.
So I know exactly where they can go from here, you know? Sometimes you just have to just brush it off, you understand? She'll come around again, you know?
All right, take it easy.
One of the when you reach certain age in life, you know, the apology thing doesn't work because you feel like you're above doing it, you understand? You'll never get an apology from grandma.
Well, I tell you something. I don't have to do certain things here either.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right.
Okay, Pastor.
Okay, take it easy.
Let me hear your laugh tonight before the game. Before the.
You know, you might have started to listen late because somebody said something earlier and cracked me up, and I did laugh.
Maybe the football distracted me because Kansas City beat New England like they've never been beat before. 41-14.
All right, okay.
All right, Pastor.
What I know I need here, I'll be glad is to get... No, can't say that. Mm-mm.
Come, say it. Spit it out.
No, I should have brought it, and I didn't.
Well, okay, all right.
You know, I'll have a double dose tomorrow.
All right, Pastor. No,
take it easy. Bye-bye. Mm-hmm. Let me take another call. Hello.
Yeah, Pastor.
Yes.
Grandma, actually, apologize, please, sir. And sorry about it, sir.
But you can't apologize for Grandma.
No, actually, but I'm going to come back on the show today, dear Pastor.
She doesn't need to come back tonight at all.
No, not tonight. I'm not going to come back tonight, sir.
Uh-huh.
But I'm going to come back. Dear Pastor, you know what I said to you?
Uh-huh.
One good friend here, Mr. Gary. Gary, I am Mr. Eric. I'm best FM. Lord bless you for weekend time.
Is that right?
I listen to Dear Pastor. Yes, Dear Pastor. And I know them. I listen to you right now.
Yes.
Bless up your gear. I am Mitzi. from Best FM, and love talk about you. And him give me a proper parable and say, soon come up with dear pastor. And just I wish you that day. But then talk about you a weekend.
They wish to come up with what?
Sir?
They need to do what? They wish to do what?
They know what going to come up for you shortly.
Uh-huh.
I won't let you push out of the back.
All right.
And me know. And my brother didn't want me to say, well, we are in being like you, William. And the first night you sit up and listen to you, they know why him and his wife, Marcia. No respect, my brother.
All right. God and bless. Bye-bye.
I look for you, but I won't tell you why, but you will know later when we talk.
All right.
All right, my brother.
Bye-bye. Good, good. Mm-hmm. Bye-bye. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Hello, welcome to dear pastor.
Good night, pastor.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm here.
Uh-huh.
I'm here. But him start let the puss out of the bag already.
Who left the puss?
This caller that just talked.
Uh-huh, what did he say? I couldn't hear him very well.
He's saying that them coming up to see you one day.
Oh, okay.
He said, no, let it put out of the bag, but he said, let it out already. I just tune in, no. I never know what will go on, and I just tune in.
Oh, well, you don't know the topic?
No, sir, I just wake up.
Oh, yeah, you told me you sleep and you're sleeping often.
Yeah, man.
Why are today's women so bossy and controlling?
Why these ladies always want in command, you know? They always want to be in command.
They want to control you all the time?
Every time. We're not saying them can't control, you know. Right?
Mm-hmm.
But them want control everything.
Mm.
That means anything you do, you have to talk with them. And everything sometimes you do later to know where you're going. She have to know. Sometimes you need to go to the road to go knock to them know where you're in front and you just sneak out and go and then when you come in, they know what. Because you have to know where you went, what were you doing, and et cetera, and so forth. But that's how these ladies stay, you know.
Mm-hmm.
One time, ladies, them never really stay that way. But them women know demands and then determine. Them have to lead.
What do you think about that?
Boy. That's the way, you know, and you now get them out of it, you know.
Well, you know, the thing about it, you know, a man should not object, you know, if a woman is sharing with him.
Depends on what they're sharing, sir.
What do you mean?
No, you said sharing with him.
Yeah. I mean,
conversation.
All right, let me put it this way. If a woman is working, and she is getting $100,000 a month.
Right.
You making $100,000 a month. Suppose both of them put together, that's $200,000.
That is correct.
$1,000. And you have a budget. And she put X amount, and you put X amount. That's a sharing.
Yes.
So you're sharing the bills. There's nothing wrong in that, you know.
Nothing wrong, but sometimes she always, let you have to put, she put 50, you have to put 75.
Yeah, some women say what they work for is theirs.
Their own.
And what you work for is both.
Both of you take charge of that. Yeah, but that's how they stay. I mean, I take up the whole of the time at the program now, fast as usual.
Yeah.
What's your name, call it? What's your name again? Miss Joan's name?
You mean Joan?
Yeah, she called already.
No.
The one who give me trouble day and night.
Oh, you mean the one? No, that was S. Oh, yeah. And you threw out a challenge to her, eh?
Yes.
Yeah, she called now.
Oh, she called already.
Mm.
Okay. say, well, at least I will hear her tomorrow night.
Maybe she called back now that she has heard you.
All right, Pastor, you take good care.
And God be with you.
And see your brother, one brother.
Thank you.
Okay.
We take a break.
You're listening to Power 106 FM.
Welcome back to Dear Pastor. I'm Dr. Dumas, your host. And let me take a call. Hello.
Hello, Pastor. Sorry for call back.
No, not at all. You go ahead.
No, I'm listening now, so I understand, and then I love to hear what other people have to say, and then I can comment.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I would love to comment on the topic.
Yes.
And why women today is so bossy?
Ah.
The problem today with men and women is now no good communication with couples anymore. Because I think it's very, very nice if I know where my husband are.
Mm.
And he know where I am. It's the same like we say, it's important to know where your children are, who they
are. Yes.
Their friends and all these things. It's exactly the same for a couple to have a good relationship and to show respect for each other. If my husband put on his clothes and go out the door and don't say anything to me, I would feel embarrassed.
I see what you're saying.
I would wonder, what have I done?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
What's going on? Because we don't used to that.
Right.
And I wouldn't accept that from a man either.
Yes.
And I don't expect to do it to them either.
Mm-hmm.
Because when two people are together, it's very important to know where the other one are, especially in today's days. If something happens somewhere, you hear that a car crash or a plane, I say, wonder if he's there. And you're going to try to find out if he's there and try to help if at the same time if you can help. You want to make sure everything is okay. But today, if you ask your partner, where are you going, it's a quarrel start.
Yeah.
They start a quarrel because I ask, where are you going? I'm not talking about me, Pastor, because I'm not living this kind of life. But I know these things happening. But for me, I'm not going to accept these things because I'm a nice, kind person, but I'm strict.
Yes.
You understand me, Pastor? And the best thing what makes me most happy in my life is when I can share. Whether it's my husband, my family, friend, sharing is what the most thing for me that make me most happy is sharing.
Yes, I understand.
I feel so happy when I can share something. Whether it is love, it's material thing, whatever, that make me happy and proud. I told you before, Pastor, I work, my husband work, we share the bills, all the bills. What he have leave is for him, I don't care what he do with it. What I have is for me, I don't care, he don't ask me what I do with it. He had his own account, I had my own account. You understand what I mean, Pastor?
I read you, long time, I understand.
And that make me proud because I can wait. I'm gonna have free this weekend. I can wake up Saturday, Friday morning and say to my husband, I'm not working today. And you are not working tomorrow. Let's take a trip to England, anywhere we want to go, where we can afford. He don't have to pay. I can pay too. How we share. Sometimes he pay for me, sometimes I pay for him. He don't ask me. I don't ask him. It's come from my heart.
Yes. I understand.
That is my contribution for tonight on your topic.
And the Lord be with you.
Respect, sharing, and caring.
Yes. All right. God bless. Well, that's it from you. And take another call. Hello. Hello? Hello, welcome to dear Pastor. All right, let me just, let me read something here. And before we take the break, yeah, I'm going to just read maybe two or three comments from my Facebook page. I'm going to try and read all of them tonight. And here is Marie. She said, ha, 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 because there are not enough responsible men. And then she is responding to the topic, why are today's women so bossy and controlling? But good over evil, I don't know what that means, says, maybe some men allow it. And then Tanya says, times have changed and more women are independent, can pay their own bills, and don't have to rely on a man. The men nowadays looking for a woman to take care of them. The tables have turned, and it seems like the men wearing the skirts and the woman wearing the pants. Laugh out loud, eh? Well, let me take another call. Well, those come from Facebook, but I have comments on my Facebook page, and I have more. Let me take a call. Hello.
Hello. Good night, Pastor.
Uh-huh. How you doing?
I'm okay so far, Pastor.
Mm-hmm. Go right ahead.
Yes, sir. I'd like to hear your topic once more for the night.
You want to hear your topic again?
Sir.
Oh, Lord. Why are today's women so bossy and controlling?
Well, Pastor, my honest opinion is men leave their position abandoned. They abandon their position. They say they are the head. Yes, they are the head. But to do the work of the head, no. They leave that space abandoned, so most times the woman have to do the job of the woman and of the man.
Hold on, you said the women have become bossy because the men have what?
Abandoned their position, sir.
Oh yes?
Yes, sir.
It's like being in the military and you should stay at the post and you move.
Yes, sir, and I have to cover my post and your post, and you wouldn't like it, so I won't like it for long.
Oh, my. Mm.
So you do it for this period, and you do it that this period and next period, and then, you know, you can't do it again in peace, because, you see, at all times, the person leaving what they're supposed to do, you have to be doing it.
Mm.
And that's nice. And it's coming up. And the other thing about money spending, you can imagine you as a man, all right, I'm not talking you now.
That's all right.
Working $10 and the woman working $2 and the woman can show her $2 and your $10 can't show it. It's not nice. So I don't know who wanna quarrel. So most time when you hear most men, the woman is bought and controlling, all because they leave their position abandoned. And when you have to do the two shifts, it's not easy. You're tired and get weary and miserable also.
All right, now listen to me. Let me take the break. Can you hold?
I don't know for how long my credit.
All right, well, and listen, I want to thank you. You have made a good input.
Okay,
have you ever called?
No, sir, this is the first time.
First time. We love you and thank you so much for your contribution.
Of
sir. Have
all
a
right,
day.
Bye-bye.
You're listening to Power 106 FM. The time is now.
It's 29 minutes to 12. Welcome back to Dear Pastor, I'm Dr. Dumas, your host. Let me take a call. Hello.
Hello, Pastor.
Yes, sir.
Good night.
How you do, brother?
Okay, your topic tonight is a very powerful one.
Thank you.
But what really happened, my point of view is, most of the women in these times are very ambitious.
Yeah.
And they are capable of handling things. And they notice every little thing that is to be done, that the man should do.
Mm-hmm.
But as soon as the man realizes that she can manage, she can get things together, the man relax.
Yes.
And start to waste his time. And then it turned around. The woman realized that she alone is doing everything.
Mm.
And he becomes like a puppet. So she started demanding and pushing, you are here and that is to be done. And if I don't tell you to do it, you don't know. The bill is coming up such a time and I don't hear you say anything and what have you. So that is how it happens.
Yeah, there are some men, you know, really and truly, they leave everything to the woman.
Yeah. So she eventually pushed him around like a little boy.
Yeah, I believe you.
You understand? And that's where it is.
Mm-hmm.
You know, my speech never too long, but it's always good. All right?
I thank you.
Yeah, yeah.
As usual.
Yes, yes, sir.
God bless.
Yes.
All right. Let me take another. Hello, welcome to Dear Pastor.
Hello, is it my time?
Yes.
All right, good night, Dear Pastor.
Mm.
I hope you're, I've heard what took place, so I hope you're in good mood, right?
If I'm in a good mood?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, man, what, nothing went wrong.
All right, all right. No, I'll listen to the topic. That's very interesting.
Mm-hmm.
But I thought more ladies would be calling to,
You really?
Huh?
You wanted more ladies to call?
Yeah, because you said ladies. Well, ladies are bossy, are women. Yeah. But so
why are today's women so bossy and controlling, eh?
Right, right. Mm. Call, but I was listening to two callers and they asked what the topic was, but they never say why. Talking, repeating the topic. For example, June, she was going on, but she never said why. And the other man who works for June, he never said why.
Mm-hmm.
They're bossy, but why? You ask why.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so I'm going to tell you what I believe. You know, first of all, some of the men, they neglect their responsibilities, as some caller said. Some of them not very responsible. Because I can give myself as example. So when I was married, my husband left everything up to me.
Oh yes.
Do you want to do anything? No. If my yard is to be cut, I had to go tell him. He go in his bed, wrapping up in the sheet, and then I have to put it down. They don't be allowed to cut. And besides that, nowadays, women are more dedicated. Women get more education than before.
Mm.
And women are working now. Once upon a time, women used to stay home. They used to stay home while the men were money. So the man bought them, but now women were their own money. they are more professional women. Women are emerging as leaders. So things have changed. And so, when you have some women more than men, I use more than my husband, but I didn't bother me. Because I know if women are working more money, they're going to feel on top, or they're going to get more independence.
Problem?
His problem? Jealousy.
Oh, yes?
That was very funny. Yes, yeah, he was jealous because I used to tell him, why don't you go to school, upgrade yourself? And he was like, oh, every minute I'm telling him to go to school, why am I telling him to do that? So, you know, I mean, and I didn't have a problem with it. He had the problem. Because he said women shouldn't be earning more money, what I did, and he saw it as a problem. I told him it was not a problem to me, but he felt away, you know.
Why?
But they abandon their responsibility. They don't want to upgrade themselves. A lot of men don't upgrade themselves. They let the woman upgrade or leave them. And so when the lady have her money, she's going to be bossy.
Is that right?
Some of them are, you know, I shouldn't generalize, but, you know, most of them. When you have your money, you feel good, you know. Independent, you can do things. You don't have to go depend on nobody. When you depend on a man, sometimes they get abusive to you because, you know, they get frustrated when the bills come and they can't pay it. So it's good for the woman also to have money and to share. You know, if you can share with the husband, it's fine. But, you know, sometimes it doesn't always work like that, you know, because one person never gets jealous.
He said he wanted to leave you.
Well, he never said he didn't say he wanted to, but what he things he did led up to that. He would be gone. Like, you know, a lot of Jamaican, like somebody mentioned, you want to go play domino. You're always out there playing domino. You know, you have a home. You don't look after you. You're sitting playing domino with your friends. That's not nice. And you leave. Most of the time I'm here by myself. And then when the man come in, I say, where are you? Oh, with my friends. I say, am I not your friend? Am I your friend too? So, I am your friend too. But they just say, oh, I'm going to play domino. And they're not considering and thinking.
Yeah.
They need to do that.
All right, thank you.
Just say, I'm going to play domino with my friend, and you can't ask me nothing. What kind of thinking is that?
No, that's bad.
Yeah, lot of them do that.
Yes.
I expect you not to say something.
I thank you for your input tonight.
All right, thank you, Pastor.
Love you and keep sweet.
All right, thank you.
Bye-bye. Take a break.
You're listening to Power 106 FM. The time is now
15 minutes to 12.
Are you tired of high energy costs? Stop complaining and call Green Energy Savings Limited. We sell and design grid-tie and off-grid energy solar systems, LED bulbs, outdoor solar lighting, solar flashlights, solar and gas water heaters. Green Energy Savings Limited will reduce your energy cost, guaranteed. Don't be held captive by the outrageous cost of electricity. There is a solution. Call Green Energy Savings Limited, 946-3166. That's 946-3166.
Island Smiles, orthodontic providers with a highly trained staff dedicated to creating an environment where all patients receive loving and high-quality care in a comfortable atmosphere. Island Smiles, great smiles, good dental health, 20 Hillcrest Avenue, Kingston 6.
It's the first of its kind in Jamaica. Stimulating, informative, fearless, and penetrating. Sports Globe, Jamaica's sports tabloid, your ultimate sports paper. Sports Globe, available on all newsstands island-wide. Take a closer look at persons in the sporting arena, the medals, the records, and the accolades. Sports Globe, revealing all the stories that sports fans love.
We have a vision of a connected world, a more accessible world. So we are building gateways in over 80 countries around the globe, connecting people, cities, countries, cultures, through highways, railways, bridges, ports, and airports. Wherever the challenge is most demanding, you can count on us to get the job done. China Harbor Engineering Company Limited, building a connected world.
Over the years, Arden alumni have bonded together in an effort to promote and enrich the academic, cultural, physical, and social development of Arden. On Tuesday, September 30, the Arden alumni will host the press launch of the Arden Alumni Foundation at the Arden Undercroft, 10 Arden Road, Kingston. Join us during Cliff Hughes Online as we bring you live coverage. This broadcast comes to you courtesy of Telstar Cable Limited and Office of the Children's Advocate. That's Cliff Hughes Online live from the Arden Alumni Foundation press launch on Tuesday, September 30, right here on Power 106 FM.
Come and visit us at the Shirilla Inn Hotel. Take a peaceful break to relax and rejuvenate on Negril's white sandy beaches. While you're here, enjoy our fine selection of French wines and French Jamaican cuisine. Take pleasure in our traditional Jamaican folkloric music and African drumming every Saturday night, and our Thursday night jazz, blues, and vintage reggae cabaret, starting time 7:30 p.m. Visit www.shirilla.com for more information.
Welcome back to Dear Pastor. I'm Dr. Dumas. Let me take a call. Hello?
Pastor.
Yes?
Give thanks to life, man.
Ah, man, how you doing?
Well, you see that lady who talk about the domino?
Yeah,
she wouldn't agree, because I love domino.
Yeah.
I love to play domino, buddy. That's one of my games that I play.
Yes.
And sometimes you have to give the man a little leeway. Nobody says that you should leave your every night call and go and play domino with him, friend. But if you want to learn to play domino too, you can play Kayar too.
Yes.
So what she need to do is to learn the game, that him not have no excuse to go out every night, because your town can't play too.
Oh, yeah.
Right. Or you go over the neighbor and the town play, or you invite the neighbor over and play. So you not have to left go amongst your friends with them. As I said, she need to learn the game, that he might not have that excuse. Pastor, I catch the chicken going viral.
You can and, really?
Yeah, and every giant number body peeing up. I went to the hospital from about 4 o'clock. And being there till after 10 in the night, going up to 11.
Hey, what are you saying to me?
Only to be told that there's nothing we can do about it. All you need to do is take some Panadol and rest. After me did a wait so long, but I cliff you let me do it in a virgin, because I know that them I was saying. I must say, if you go, because I want to lose me and it can be dengue and all that. They said they don't determine which one it is. No, they don't. Nothing is in Jamaica to determine. So Jamaica don't have a machine that can determine whether or not it's dengue. They must say yes, but they don't do it to people because the symptoms are the same and I see them treatment. I have to wait from 4 till after 10. We just try to help you, know.
Imagine that.
Just tell them, man, and all them are virgin. There's nothing we can do. Just go home, go take some Panadol and get some rest. Imagine that. I mean, if you say, I'm going to the doctor, because we know that him have been no. The doctor will tell the minister of health whether they have any cases they treat. But, you know, make no sense, because them now do not must give you two Panadol, and they don't know whether a chicken goon or a dengue, because they now do not test to find out. Then just treat the symptoms, and that's it. Give some painkiller, and something to bring down a fever, and I eat that. So you have to treat it to your own self, so you get some guinea hen weed and some busy and some neem and boil them separately and drink them and treat it yourself, because doctor not do nothing towards it. Your topic now, why some women are bossy?
Yeah.
Some women, you know, because they are in a financial position above the man, they use that as a big stick over the man's head. They will set the terms and conditions. Some of them who are in that position, they don't do it, but there are some who will do it and have been doing it. So because they're in a better financial position than the man, they will use that and manipulate the man's self-esteem. When they go out with the man, the man has to introduce the man as her chauffeur. And the man can't take part in that. The discussion with them, because she don't proud of the man and they are big tapanaris people them. She don't want to know, say, well, our man is not probably intelligent enough to talk.
That's disgraceful.
Of course it is. He will not introduce, he will not talk about the man being the chauffeur while the man is there, you know. But while the man is across the room, he will say, okay, yeah, that's my chauffeur there. You know, so and then in treat the man as a chauffeur. And that destroy a man totally, man. And women need to know that. So my man them give them reasons to really take over and run things still, you know, because some of my man don't really play the role of a man. So the woman will have to step in and do what's necessary for the family to stay together and run the family. Because the woman are the first economist, you know.
Yeah.
The woman can stretch the dollar to the point of breaking it. And no matter how much you give a woman, some woman will put on one little much out every rainy day. So some of the woman will not stay there and know, say, well, boy, the man will be there and you know, put on nothing and he'll go drink off the money and things. They might put on sitting one side. I'm not talking about the woman and we'll squander it and all kind of
thing. I know what you mean.
Right. A well thinking woman will always have something stashed away for a rainy day, have to bring the family member to the doctor in case of emergency. But bossy women are just being women who feel more or less who I have more money for you, man. You can't come tell me what to do. I spend my own money. You know, finance me. So they will pass me. Well, Pastor, give thanks again.
No, but I don't want you to go. Now, let me ask a question. I mean, what is it about money that would make a woman change like that?
No, because a woman feel more powerful spending her own money, you know. Rather than each time she wants something, she has to come ask the man for it. She just feel unachieved when every time she wants something, she has to ask the man. But when she's spending her own money, she's powerful. And the man cannot dictate to her ask her why she going to buy all of that. Why she ever spend so much money upon that? Because her money. And that him tell the man. And she works it and have her money. So money make a big difference in the bossiness of woman.
Mm.
Yeah, man.
All right. Thank you so much.
Yes, thanks.
Bye-bye. Oh, boy. I was reading... I should take another? All right. Okay. Hello. Hello, welcome to dear Pastor.
Good night, dear Pastor.
Yes.
Most interesting listening, I think, is Raskava, that, no?
Yeah, that's Raskava.
Boy, sorry about that chicken gunya thing.
Yeah.
But he says everything which I probably would have said, money and power. And of course, education. That is what sometimes they use over the men.
Yes.
And it's not only in the home, even in the workplace when they have position,
mm-hmm.
they lord it over the other people, especially the men.
Yeah, so now it seems to me then, therefore, that a man has to keep up to?
Keep up to, yes, precisely.
Yeah.
Step up to the plate and, you know, just try to do what he can do to improve himself too.
One caller, I'm pretty sure you heard her, who said that her husband did not upgrade himself.
I heard her, but she keep hopping on her position and her money.
Mm-hmm.
You know, which says a lot too.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you get that feeling of superiority.
Yes.
You know, but as you said, the men have to step up to the plate. But quickly, dear Pastor, the gentleman there with his son who, more or less, so taking advantage of him.
Yeah.
Did he made reference to your, the Bible speaks yesterday, which he always do?
No, he didn't say it yesterday. But
because when I listened, I was trying to see the relation, because I just came in just when he was speaking, eh?
Uh-huh.
And I reflected on your sermon yesterday.
Yes.
And where you referred to about children going to university, getting a good education through their parents who make a lot of sacrifice.
And that's the truth.
And how they treat with their parents who are usually poor.
Right.
And what have you. And some of them may even ignore them.
Oh, yeah, totally.
So I was wondering, and because he made reference to the fact that he helped his son to get a good job.
Yes.
And to have a supervisory position, it means that you must have a good, relatively good education.
Uh-huh, true.
You understand? And for him to be treating his father like that, you know, and at that age, you should be on your own and stop messing around your parents and stop being a crook, because this is how some of them want to have the demise of their parents, that they can benefit from what is there. And also in your sermon, to which I pointed out, and I'm saying this respectfully to one of your popular callers who usually make reference to the poor, because in that same sermon you made something about you have overheard our people making comments about people being poor.
Yes.
And the way they put down with poor people. So I'm saying respectfully, he must be careful how he uses this term about you don't even like to hear the word poor. Because remember, the poor will always be with us.
Indeed.
And how we treat with the poor is another matter.
That's true.
So we have to be very careful, and I would, as I say, respectfully, you should rethink about even making mention of the poor as if you're putting down people.
Yeah.
Your pastor, you keep up your job.
And I thank you so much for the call, man. Always good hearing from you.
Most welcome.
God bless. Bye-bye. Well, you know what I'm going to have to do? I'm going to have to read some of these comments tomorrow night. Both the text messages and the face comments on Facebook. I want to thank you for listening tonight. I want to thank you for calling. I want to thank Tamika for working with me tonight. And in the will of the Lord, I'll be back on Tuesday approximately 9 p.m. and we'll do another show. So wherever you are, you take good care of yourself, and may God watch over you. 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 Watch over you.